Okay, so yesterday our Afghan president, Afghanistan's president, Ashraf Gandhi, member of the Gandhi family, Mahatma Gandhi, Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi, Sonia Gandhi, Ashraf Gandhi. So our buddy Ashraf Ghani, he apparently took 165 million and fled the country. So before the narrative was he's going to broker a peace deal with the Taliban. Following that, they said, okay, he ran away from the country. Following that, they said, oh, he ran away with bags full of cash, and cash was flying out of the helicopter. And finally, they said, oh, he ran to Tajikistan or Turkmenistan or some stan. And finally, one of my friends, he said, Loy, Ashraf Ghani is in UAE. But he said, don't share it until I tell you when. So I said, okay, fine. So after he gave me the confirmation, I immediately uploaded the screen grab, the screenshot, you know, a Photoshop image. And I said that this guy is in UAE. And I sent it to people that I know. And then I got one guy who sent me a screenshot from the UAE government official site. Ashraf Ghani is in UAE on humanitarian grounds. Okay. So now the question is, what's my opinion? Is he a good guy? Is he a bad guy? Is he a crook? He ran away with the money. You know, was that wrong? I'll give my thoughts. And yes, the fact that he's in the UAE. Okay. Let's take one thing at a time. There are too many things. First one, Ashraf Ghani. If you read a little bit about him, you know, who's Ashraf Ghani, you'll realize that this guy, I don't know, does he have an American citizen? But he was in America, good education, educated guy, and a professor, intelligent guy. A professor, well-spoken. So he was a professor at one of the top colleges. And, you know, then with a strange, shocking twist of events, this guy was made the president out of nowhere. He was not in the political limelight. He was not in the field of politics. You know, there are many politicians who are into politics right from a very young age. He was not into politics. He was more of a professor, an educator. Now, all of a sudden, out of the blue, he was made this president. It kind of reminded me of Donald Trump. You know, all of a sudden, he decided to run for the presidency and became. Now, this is my thought. Okay, remember, whenever anyone is put in a position of power, suddenly out of nowhere, out of the blue, you can be rest assured this person is a puppet, is a spokesperson. Okay? It's not to say that, you know, Barack Obama, who his whole life he was into politics, or Joe Biden, whole life into politics, they are not a puppet. Yes, once you are at that position, there are people more powerful than you who will tell you, just do what, you know, we say. Otherwise, we don't need you. Same way, like if you're a CEO of a company, people assume that, oh, he can do whatever he likes. No, you're responsible to the board, you're responsible to the stock market, you're responsible to shareholders, you're responsible to so many people, man. You have to play that diplomatic game, you know. However, in the case of Ashraf Ghani, just like Donald Trump, he was bought there to be the face. Now, from being a professor, lecturer, all of a sudden running a country, come on, man. you don't develop those skills overnight. Ashraf Ghani was a mouthpiece, a spokesperson, a puppet for the US. The US had its agenda in Afghanistan. They had their reasons. I spoke to some ex-military, you know, half, they're retired, hi-fi guys, and they were giving me different name, Masood and Abu something, and too complicated. They actually fought in the war, huh? These guys who I was talking to, they fought in the war, and you'll be like, why the fuck should they speak to you? Because they see my videos, okay, and I talk of UAE, and these guys are based in UAE, these ex-CIA, ex-army, ex-military, ex-whatever. And some of them have even worked as mercenaries. Okay. So if you see, you may not believe me because nobody approaches you. I'll tell you, start being a public figure, have a social media presence, talk about the news and all that. People will approach you, reporters, journalists, news people. So I've been put in this position by luck that I got all these really, you know, very unique individuals. Yes, I do get some people who are wannabe CIA, wannabe I was ex-military. You can make out who's fake, who's real by just, you know, and sometimes you can't fool people every time. Anyway, so this guy, Ghani, was the mouthpiece for USA. Everything was going on fine. Now, everything was going on fine until he was in power. And then when he lost his election, they put him back through fraudulent means. USA, they can create the rules, they can bend the rules. See, here's my question. Who created Osama bin Laden? Who created? Who was good friends with, what is his name? Gaddafi, Saddam Hussein. All these guys, the Taliban, all these were created by USA. Who supplies the weapons? USA. USA will one day make you enemy of my enemies, my friend. Okay, we have to fight USSR. Chal, we like you. You're a freedom fighter. We'll supply you the weapons, technology, attack them. And then afterwards, when USA tries to stab the very, kill the very people they make, they turn against them. Like, for example, 9/11. It takes common sense to understand the most advanced technologically, the most superior advanced technological country in the world, with the technology that is mind-boggling. A guy in a mountain with a rifle, mountain where internet is also not available, he was able to infiltrate that. It's like you and me, we just know how to play computer games. We know how to open Word and close Windows and put on the computer and switch off. Oh fuck, is that a snake? That is a snake. Dead? Yeah, dead. Okay, thank you. Want to see close up? Say snake. Okay, I think you can see red ants are eating it. Okay, anyway. Entertainment. So, what I was saying was, it's like me and you who only know how to play computer games. Tetris, all of a sudden it's in the news. We hacked the CIA, FBI offices and destroyed the network of the entire world. People who know us will be like, huh? This guy, he didn't even know how to switch on his PC. You know, there are some people who, they'll say the PC is not working. Then when you check, the power plug is not connected. So it's like that. Osama bin Laden, come on, man. And then after, you know, September 11, they found what passports? Saudi passports and UAE passport. But who did they attack? Saddam Hussein, Afghanistan. No, sorry, Afghanistan they attacked. What sense does it make, man? Okay, anyway. So Ghani was, as long as Ghani was in power, he would take instructions from USA. After all, studied in USA. I think residency in USA. Benefits from USA. Okay. So this is not a guy who came into power by rallying an entire nation behind him like for example, Imran Khan. He has a strong, very strong political support. Even if we agree, disagree with him, he has come the hard way. Okay. Like Modi, they've come up the hard way. So now this guy, he didn't have the power, support of the people. And he is fighting an enemy that is way too powerful, the Taliban. So as long as Big Brother USA is there, we will fight, we will peace, we will this. USA whispers in here, say this, say this, say this. He has a script. He'll take the script, he'll do. As long as he dances to their music, he's in power. Now, what happened all of a sudden is beyond my comprehension. Yeah, all of us can have urban legends and rumors and conspiracy theories. And USA decided to withdraw. To the shock of everyone. I don't know whether Biden is also a puppet. He's too old, man. He doesn't even know where the fuck he's walking. I don't even, you know, I just wonder like how, like he must be suffering from dementia or something. Okay, so this guy will repeat whatever the script writer tells him. Okay. So now this guy, someone tells him, say, listen, withdraw all the people from Kabul, from, sorry, Afghanistan. So, okay. And the thing is, he doesn't announce this. They secretly start pulling people out. And then once everyone is ready to get out, as they're ready to get out, he announces. Now imagine, he has not informed NATO. He has not informed our strategy. If you listen to any of the news bullshit, the briefing, what do they say? Our strategic partners, our alliances. We have developed the... Oh, fuck all. You can just memorize some nice key-sounding words and sound intelligent. Our strategic partners, our NATO alliance, our... the power of democracy and blah, blah, blah. The people of Afghan deserve better, blah, blah, blah. Okay. So it was like more like fuck you to everyone. At least Donald Trump used to say fuck you and mean it. Biden says our strategic partners and then stabs them at the back. So he didn't give a fuck about UK's people, Europe, NATO's citizens. He didn't give a fuck about anyone. He just decided, I'm going to withdraw all my American troops. Because if he doesn't, the Americans will complain, he will lose ratings. So now, they must have informed of this guy. See, listen, Ghani, listen, buddy. No use being here, we are going. Okay, you do what you have to save your ass. He was like, I'm just a professor. You told me, like, you remember Iron Man, the Mandarin, when Iron Man catches the guy, the Mandarin used to make videos. He turned out to be an actor. I just follow instructions. So this Afghani was like, I was just acting. So they said, listen, don't need to worry. Because you are the public figure, we'll make sure you don't get killed. Just take whatever you have to, take your family and follow these instructions. First, say that, don't worry, we'll be there. And slowly wait. Taliban, on the other hand, they were waiting. I wouldn't be surprised if USA purposely leaked the information to inform the Taliban, listen, you take over, do it slowly, and then we can have the transition, whatever. Taliban, it's like, you know, you didn't have sex for 20 years. All of a sudden, they're telling you, listen, there are a couple of naked girls, 5,000 of them. Just take one girl at a time for the next, every day, one girl. For a guy who didn't have sex for 20 years, you think they'll only take one girl at a time? They will fucking come running in droves and they will gobble up every girl. They will not leave. Just imagine, you didn't have sex for many days. Many, many days. and then you get this seductive female in front of you. What are you going to do? Stand there and, "You're my sister, let's get to know each other." No, you'll just rip your clothes and jump. Same thing happened with our Taliban. Opportunity of a lifetime. Come on, guys, let's all go. However, this time the Taliban, they're much more smarter, much more intelligent. They were like, "Listen, if you have to survive, we can't survive by murdering and killing, because then they will attack us again and we'll have issues. So what we'll do is, we'll just play the American game. We will have press conferences like America. We'll give sweet sounding words like America. Like France, we will say freedom of speech. But then, like how they jail people who talk about Jews, they say anti-Semitism. We'll also say we are open-minded. We love everyone. We believe in democracy. But secretly, we'll do our shit. Like America say, we respect the rights and privileges and secrecy. But then, you know what happened to Snowden? He exposed America spies on its own citizens. So, Taliban took a page out of America and now is playing the same game. Now, the funny thing is, here's the funny thing. America can't do jack shit to the Taliban. You know why? If they have to do jack shit, they need to have their balls in their hand, no? Taliban people don't have a bank account. They don't have US dollar account. They don't have investment in USA treasury bonds like Iran, Venezuela. They don't have bank accounts. So America can squeeze the balls of Venezuela. Okay, your 1 billion is here. Fuck you, we're not giving it. Iran, you have trillions here. Sorry, now fuck you, what you'll do. Now Taliban, what they'll do? Huh? Fuck, there's no banker. What the fuck can we do now? So USA is in a very helpless, embarrassing situation. So that is why they're not addressing it. But they like to show we are strong. Now we play the game of poker. Now, so Ashraf Ghani. He was like, what the fuck to do? Okay. He told me fuck off, okay. So the poor guy, like B.R. Shetty, or like anybody who flees the country, took all the money, like these cryptocurrency guys who want to fraud, in a suitcase and ran. And obviously he wants to go to a tax-free country. Tax-free country where nobody asks you where you got the black money from. Oh, we have to hand you over to this authority, that authority, and there's no other place like Dubai. Qatar is also there. Saudi, he doesn't want Islamic rule. You know, MBS can be a funny guy. You don't know when he'll suddenly turn around and fuck your happiness. Remember Ritz-Carlton. So he says, Dubai. I can retire in the sun. Relax. Tax-free. Expo 2020. I will stand in the Afghanistan pavilion and shake hands. Take an autograph. $20. So like every other fraudster, guy with black money. I told you, no? How many times I told you? You have billions of dollars. Dubai is the paradise for you, as long as you keep a low profile. So it seems this guy with the commandos and all the big guys of UAE, they made sure that this guy was protected and brought safely with his family. Okay, to UAE. UAE is doing a smart thing. Come. See, USA, we took care of your puppet. USA, good. But officially, we are not going to say that you took care of our puppet. Unofficially, thank you. We'll take care of you also. Don't worry, man. Expert 2010, don't worry. Yeah, I'm there for you. Don't worry. Okay. Now comes the part of that 165 million. Now, I'm pretty sure you'll say, what a bastard. Fuck, he took 165 million. Hey, listen, man. If you're planning to run away from a country, leave all your property, leave all your houses, leave all your land. You need money, right, to feed you and your family. What are you going to do? Leave all the money and say, oh no, this is for the Afghani people. I will go empty-handed and live hand to mouth. I'll do farming. I will work. I will scrub the floor. I'll work in McDonald's. He has not done anything wrong. See, this guy Ashraf, who has he killed anyone? No. Has he murdered anyone? No. Has he done anything illegal? We don't know. But for that matter, which politician has a clean slate? So he has just taken the money for him and his family to enjoy retirement life. 165 million. If he spends 1 million every year, he'll have 165 years. If he spends 2 million, 80 years. You know, 3, 4, 4 million for what is it? You know, 40 years. So, I don't know, I'm bad at maths. So, anyway, look, he has done what he needs to protect him and his family. He gives a fuck to what you think. I don't know what you expect. The 165 million he has to keep for the Taliban, those guys. They will sell it off anyway. You tell me, if you have 100 million that you can carry with you, are you going to leave it? So stop acting stupid, man. He did whatever he had to enjoy his life. Retirement. It's called the retirement package. So overall, like they say, all is well that ends well. Afghani needed to come to a tax-free country. He got it. Our Ashraf Ghani, sorry. He wanted a tax-free country. He got it. He wanted a country where black money, nobody will ask you where you got it from. He got it. You know, he wanted some nice Islamic country, but modernization. He got it. He had a nice beach. He can buy, he can get a gold visa, investor visa. Plus, nobody will harass him in UAE. Plus, it's an ally of USA. Plus, his family can study in a nice college school and enjoy retirement. And there's security, thanks to Israel. Israel's technology, there's security. Nobody is going to assassinate him. So it ticks all the boxes. So what is wrong? You and me would have done the same thing, right? So for a guy who's not a leader, who's just a puppet, like that Iron Man, the Mandarin, he's an actor, like Ronald Reagan, like a mouthpiece, like Donald Trump, who follows instructions well. Only thing is, why like Donald Trump is, at least he's not two-faced like Biden. Biden will say, our strategic partners, our allies. And now, the poor fellow with a poker face has to say, we succeeded, like George Bush, like an idiot. We won the war. We accomplished. What the fuck? You're fucking an embarrassment. NATO doesn't trust USA anymore. Countries don't trust USA anymore. And then the shamelessness that they have. Oh, we need to know if the new government is good. We'll keep an eye. Fuck you, keep an eye on your asshole, man. You just betrayed an entire nation. And shamelessly, you're saying, no, we are keeping an eye. You'll keep an eye and do what? What the fuck are you going to do? Send your troops back? You can't do jack shit. Everyone knows that. Iran is laughing. Putin must be laughing. China must be laughing. All are laughing. But they'll keep quiet. Such a comedy joke. USA, it's leadership and it's nonsense. Anyway, this was my opinion, my view about Ashraf Ghani running away. I just say, Ashraf, enjoy your retirement life, man. You played a good role in a Hollywood movie role, like WWE, you know. You have to do kayfabe. So you played a, you know, good job in acting like the president as a leader. And now the movie production had to shut down. And you got your payout. Now enjoy your retirement. You'll die a good old man. USA will continue its nonsense. Oh, we are keeping an eye. Our strategic partners. Oh, we are back at the head of the table. America is back. Yay! Yay! Yeah. We accomplished what we had to. You know, it's like a comedy show. It's so funny, man. That old man. We accomplished what we had to do. And then he must be going in. Please give me my injections. I don't remember what I'm doing. In fact, Kamala Harris, what the fuck is she doing? You remember how much Biden was talking about the border wall is inhuman, is separating the mothers and children. What is he doing? He has made that migration even worse now. He is still continuing what Donald Trump did. He used to criticize Donald Trump and now he's continuing his policy. I mean, how much more two-faced you have to be called an American? I think that's the best statement. How much more two-faced do you have to be called an American? Because that is what American leadership is all about. Being two-faced, stabbing NATO, they fucked everyone. UK, they fucked everyone. And now they're saying, oh, we're keeping an eye. We're keeping an eye. Oh, hey, Taliban, we're looking at you. Oh, fuck. Taliban must say, suck my hairy Islamic cock. That's what they must be saying. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you guys. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. You think I'm right? You think I'm wrong? Love to hear your views. And yes, shame on USA. Shame. All those Americans, oh, we are proud. You know, I feel sad for those American soldiers who lost their legs, hands, their colleagues, their friends. That's why I say, you know, going to war, there's nothing great about it. You are just being played to fight. You lose your arm, you lose your leg, the other guy loses his arm, his leg. Politicians will sit in their nice Oval Office, enjoy sipping their latte, watching the stock market, having a free massage. And these poor guys, one arm gone, one leg gone. Oh, I fought for my country. This is... And yes, after you lose your arm and leg, they'll give you a cloth, ribbon, with one star, metal, some metal coating. You can stand and show you're proud. I died for my country. See, I lost my arm, my leg, my face, my eyes, my brain, but I got this ribbon. Okay. Feel brave. Whatever keeps floats your boat. This is politics. Anyway, let me know your thoughts. I'm glad I'm glad I'm not into politics. I'm glad I'm not into this world. I would have gone mad. Happy to be alone. All right. You guys take care. Put your thoughts and comments down below. It's me signing off. Ciao.